Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine. Let's begin with today's class. In today's class, we are going to start with our fifth chapter, that is natural disasters. So, as you heard the name natural disasters, there must be many incidents which came into your mind and you must have already studied about some of the natural disasters which we have studied in our earlier standards. Right, so today I am going to tell you about something about the natural disasters. So firstly, I would like to explain you the definition of natural disaster. What is natural disasters? So natural disaster is an event or a thing or natural disaster is an event that is caused by natural forces, right? No man is doing that thing, or it is based on natural forces. You cannot make that natural disaster happen with the help of man, right? That all thing happens naturally. Natural disasters are called with natural forces, and each year the earth experiences natural disasters. When natural disasters occur in heavily populated area, a lot of people may lose their lives. See, there is one thing very important, that whenever there are natural disasters happen in any of the area where the population of that area is more, many people lose their life. They lost their life because that disaster is so strong that human beings cannot survive on that natural force. So there are many natural disasters, like for example earthquake, tsunami, flood and volcanoes, etc. This all are the natural disaster, and that all the natural disasters came into force naturally. So I would also like to tell you something about man-made disasters, eh? See, you must have heard about two disasters: natural disasters and man-made disasters. Natural disaster is something which is made by the natural force. See, man cannot help, or man cannot stop that natural disasters. But man-made disasters, which is being created by men, is called man-made disasters. So man-made disasters can include like terrorist attacks or any bomb blast and other things, like some oil spills, and there are many chemical spills. Then there are some accidents happening. Then there are explosions, right? So this all are man-made disasters, like water spill, spilling of any oil, or spilling of groundwater contamination, and this all things are called as man-made disasters. In this chapter, we are going to study only about the natural disasters. So let's begin with today's class. On 21st March 2011, Krishna saw the picture of a tsunami in the newspaper. So there was a picture in the newspaper, and there was this girl named Krishna. She saw this picture of tsunami in the newspaper. After reaching school, she asked her class teacher, "Sir, I read the news about tsunami in the newspaper. How does a tsunami occur?" So she reached the school and she asked her class sir, and she asked that, "What I heard about tsunami, how does a tsunami occur?" So what did her sir replied? "See, natural disasters are of two types." See, one more thing very important, the natural disasters are of two types. Let's see which one is that. Disasters like earthquake, tsunami and volcano occur due to the change in the interiors of the earth. See, how does earthquake happen? If the lower layers of the earth shifts, that causes earthquake. Tsunami happens in under deep down the sea, right? Volcanoes occur in the deep of mountain, like, which means the interior part of the earth. Then there is another one, which is disaster like flood, cyclone, forest fire, drought, etc. This occurs on the surface of the earth, which means on the upper layer, right? So whenever there are changes in the interior of the earth crust, there are disasters like earthquake, tsunami and volcano. And whenever there is a change on the surface of the earth, that means the upper layer where we live, that are where human life lives, when there is change in that surface, that time this type of natural disasters occur, which are flood, cyclone, forest fire, etc. Right now our next topic is earthquake. See, we have already studied that earthquake is a natural disaster, so we are going to study how earthquake happens or what causes earthquake. The weak upper crust of the earth suddenly experiences tremors, either due to collision of plates or due to tremendous pressure in the interior of the earth. See, how does a earthquake cause? Whenever there is a weak upper crust, which means the first layer of the earth is weak and it experiences collision, which means the plates of the earth crust moves, at that time there is a very tremendous pressure, very huge pressure from the earth inside the earth, and that time earthquake comes. Waves, tremors of earthquake originate from its hypocenter, which is deep down below the surface of the earth. So when this crust moves in very deep down the earth, such sudden shaking or trembling is known as an earthquake. So whenever this type of tremendous shake inside the earth crust, which is deep down the earth crust, happens, that is known as earthquake. Earthquake waves are created from epicenter during the process of an earthquake. Earthquake occurs due to internal disturbance in the earth. So when does earthquake occurs? It occurs whenever there is a disturbance in the underground layers of our earth or in the crust of our earth, right? That time there is a tremendous shake in that layers, and because of that our earth, the upper surface of the earth, gets disturbed. So basically the earthquake occurs due to internal disturbance. There is an internal disturbance, and that is why the upper surface of the earth shakes. So this was all about earthquake. We studied about one natural disaster, that is earthquake. We are going to study about many more disasters in our coming chapter, right? So till then, keep watching the videos and we will continue our chapter in the next class. Thank you.